best pound for pound fighters in the world, even though people don't put him on the list. We all know he's there, right? Undefeated. Does it bother you when they don't put you on the list? Why?
At the end of the day, I'm getting this money, man. So I'm in the check cashing business. So
that is
true. It is what it is, and we all know who owns the Ring magazine. So that tells you everything. You know what I mean?
Every big fight you have, everyone goes against you. Mm-hmm. It's already a normal routine.
Yeah.
And you take care of business. What's gonna happen in March when you fight Keith Thurman?
I'm gonna do what I always do. I'm gonna come get the victory. I'll be unified champion again in another weight class.
I couldn't attend your last fight, but after your fight, you and Keith got into it. It was very heated. It was in the ring. What was going through your mind that time when you guys were yelling at each other? You called him into the ring, right?
Yeah, I told him to come in the ring. Well, they told him to come in the ring.
Okay.
So once he came in the ring, then I had a... I know he wasn't expecting that. So, you know, everybody used to be being quiet. So I had to catch him by surprise.
Now,
get him a little angry.
And how do you think it went afterwards? Did you talk to him since? Or?
Nah, I mean...
Just press.
I never really talked to him ever, so... I mean, he's never my friend or not, you know what I mean? So, it was what it was.
You yelled out, if you guys want to see me knock him out,
yell.
Make some noise. And what happened?
They made the whole Philly went crazy.
Where is the fight going to take place? Do we know yet?
I'm not sure yet. Either Vegas or Brooklyn. It's probably going to be, I don't know which one, to be honest with you, but I heard Brooklyn's interested the most, so that's probably where it's going to be.
Now, the winner of your fight with Thurman, there's talks it might fight Floyd. Floyd is here tonight. Did you say hello to him yet? Or?
Yeah, he said what's up to me on the when I was walking to the stage, so he showed me love or whatever.
Amir Khan is here tonight. He told me he'd like to fight you in a rematch.
Yeah,
would you like that down the line?
I think that's another big fight. I think that's one of those fights that's like destined, you know what I mean? Like, big one, the first one was so big, so the second one's going to be even bigger.
Especially now, you guys are much more famous than you were.
Exactly. And when I fought him the first time, nobody knew who I was, so this time it's going to be a lot different.
No one knew what to expect.
Exactly,
but
exactly.
I got to ask you this. Victor Ortiz, Brandon Reels, they're mixing up February 4th. I've been in camp with Brandon this whole time. He's looking tremendous. What do you think about that fight?
I think it's a good fight. I know they hate each other.
It's real.
Yeah, it's real.
It's real.
But I see some tapes, like they used to hang with each other and things like
that's
that.
That's why the beef is real.
Yeah, so I don't know how that happened, you know what I mean? But I think it's a good fight for both of them. It's a fight that they both want. They don't like each other, so it's going to be a good fight.
Now, another big fight. Conor McGregor got his boxing license.
Yeah.
What would happen if Danny Garcia stepped in the ring, a boxing ring, against Conor?
A boxing match?
Yeah.
I'm going to knock him out.
One punch? Like one round? Or?
Well, I never seen him box. I never seen him box. But, you know, just like UFC, you know, if I fought UFC, I would have to work my way to the top. You understand? I'm not going to, you know, jump in there with my first UFC fight with Conor McGregor, so I'm pretty sure he's not going to jump his first boxing match with me.
But if he did, it's good night. Bring a pillow and a blanket.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's apples and oranges, you know what I mean? So I've been boxing my whole life. I dedicated my life 18 years of boxing, so I can't let a guy who... I'm not sure if you ever boxed before or whatever, amateur or anything, but I can't let somebody who never... boxed before me.
I know Nate Diaz, who fought him twice.
Yeah.
He was at the gym in LA this week, and he said, I'm a better boxer than McGregor. I've been boxing since I was 15, and he fought. Are you familiar with Nate at all?
Yeah, I watch. I've been following it, man. For sure.
That's Marvin Hagler. You like Danny Garcia?
Of course I do.
Hey, that's a big comment, Danny.
Yeah,
that's a big comment, Marvin Hagler.
That's legendary right there.
That's so badass.
I got to put this on my Instagram, the little 15-second
clip. I'm going
to
send it to you. Marvin Hagler. Just go over and say, I want to talk to you.
Right. I hope you don't want to fight, man, because I don't want no parts of that.
So, Nate Diaz, what do you think about him? I mean, he choked out McGregor, and he's not on a pound-for-pound list. How do you beat the number one guy and everybody, and then give him, I thought he won the second one,
It's just the politics, you know what I mean? It's the politics, like, you know, the media and things like that. It's good at making people believe who's the best, you understand? Like, if you watch HBO, every week they have a new pound-for-pound champion, you know what I mean? Like, every week, you know, it's this guy, it's that guy, it's that guy. And they're good at making the public believe they have the best fighter, you know what I mean? That's good for them. They're doing a good job, so.
But you're
at the end of the day, you gotta, if you're a real fan or you really follow the sport of boxing, you really gotta sit there and do your research and you make your own list.
But I will say this, your popularity is, people don't know how popular you are.
Yeah, right.
There was a major concert, I think it was LL Cool J. Who was it? Sorry, Fat Joe?
Yeah, Fat Joe.
Brought you on stage at 20,000 people and they were going
Fat
crazy.
Fat Joe, French Montana, Meek Mill was at my fight. Allen Iverson was at my fight.
Yeah, yeah. How was that? Meek Mill is like the hottest rapper right now.
Yeah, yeah. DC4, man, the hottest thing out right now. So it's just a blessing, man. You know, at the end of the day, all them guys, we all come from the same type of, we come from the same place.
Okay.
So, like, we salute each other when, you know, we support each other when we, we're out doing.
Who would do better, Meek Mill against you boxing, or you, because I know you rap, you used to write lyrics, you against Meek Mill in a lyric competition?
Like, me boxing him, or?
Both. Who would do better? You think he would do better as a boxer than you as a rapper, or?
No, I do better as a rapper. But he's from Philly, so. Yeah.
He can fight.
Yeah, he can fight, so, but, You can't, you know, if you're from Philly, you either box or you fight. You either box or you rap, so I don't know if you're competitive, but, you know, Meek's my homie, he's cool, man.
All right, my last question for this interview, Danny Garcia. Your division right now, 147, is super deep. You have so many big names. You have Earl Spence, you have yourself, you have Keith Thurman, you have Amir Khan. Who do you think are the top five right now, the biggest names?
You know, there's all good.
Pacquiao, Mayweather, of course.
Yeah, Pacquiao's, you know, he's been in it the longest. You know, he has probably the best resume. And the most tested, you know, out of all the champions. So, you know, Pacquiao was always going to be up there because, you know, his resume. But I definitely feel like, you know, after this fight, I'll be the number one welterweight in the world. You know, this is only going to be my fourth fight. So after this fight, I have two of the belts in the division. And what can I say, man?
They keep mentioning your name for Manny. Do you hear that? Where his coach says, I want
Danny. I hear it, I've been hearing that for a long time, but I think it's possible. But I can't worry about none of that stuff right now. I got a big fight ahead of me, and my mind is on March 4th, and everything else is just talking.
All right, there you have it. Tell all the fans where to follow you on social media.
Just search Danny Swift Garcia, and you'll see the page with the little blue check. That's me.
All right, and to buy the gear for Christmas, people want to go shopping?
DSGOfficial.com.
How's it selling, by the way? Is it moving?
Oh, it's great, man. Like, I'm always sold out. I gotta hire a staff just to manage that for me. But you're doing great.
The magic man, Antonio Tarver. Right. Do you know Danny Garcia?
Of course.
What do you think about Danny?
Who don't? He's a hell of a fighter. What do I think about him? Hell of a fighter, man.
He knows boxing.
Right.
5-time champion. All right, there you have it. Danny Garcia, thanks so much. Facebook.com. I'm listening back. Reporting.
Nice to meet you, champ.
Nice to meet you.